Hello, and thank you very much for taking the time to watch this session, where we will be talking about the well-architected framework, and more specifically, the well-architected lenses. We'll give you an introduction to what the lenses are, and we'll talk about what you need to look out for in the future regarding the lenses. My name is Mandis Momberg, and I am a principal solutions architect on the well-architected team. So let's talk about well-architected. We can all agree that architecture is one of the foundational aspects of a workload in any environment. So when you look at your workloads and the workloads that your teams are building, can you answer one very specific question? Are you well architected? How confident are you that those systems are built following the best practices that we have for running workloads in the cloud? Hopefully, most of us can say, yes, we are well architected. After all, we have some great people on our teams. But how do we know? What are the metrics that we need to look at to see whether we are well architected or not? Well, that's what the well-architected framework will show you how to deduce. And what are the things that you need to look at in order to decide whether you are well architected? So why would you want to apply the AWS Well-Architected Framework to your workloads? Well, because you want to build and deploy faster. By reducing firefighting, capacity management, and by using automation, you can experiment and release more often and more value to your customers. You want to lower or mitigate your risks, because if you understand where you have risks in your architecture, and address them before they impact your business, they won't distract your team. You want to make informed decisions. You want to ensure you have made architectural decisions that highlight how they might impact your business outcomes. And you want to learn about the AWS best practices. You want to make sure that your teams are aware of the best practices that we have learned through reviewing thousands and thousands of customers running workloads on AWS. We have seen customers use the well-architected framework and achieve success and being able to answer that question of whether they are well-architected. The well-architected framework is a mechanism for your cloud journey. It allows you to learn, and it'll teach you the strategies and the best practices for architecting in the cloud. It'll show you how to measure your architecture against the best practices that we know works for our customers. And it allows you to improve your architecture by addressing any of the issues that we might help you find during your architectural review. Creating technology is a lot like constructing a physical building. If the foundation of that building is not solid, it may cause structural problems that undermine the integrity and the functioning of that building. And the same is true for software and any technical environment. So the foundations of the well-architected framework is our well-architected pillars. Those pillars are operational excellence, security, reliability, performance efficiency, and cost optimization. If you neglect any of these five pillars, it can become a challenge to build a system that delivers functional requirements and meets your business requirements. It allows to pressure and ultimately ends up disappointing your customers. But when you incorporate these pillars, it will help you produce a stable and efficient workload that allows you to focus on the functional requirements and the value of your product for your customers. What does this framework exist of? What is a part of this framework that guides you and teaches you these best practices as we know them? Primarily, we have three main parts. We have content, we have tools, and we have data. The content of the well-architected framework is in those pillars and the foundations of those pillars. It is the framework itself. It provides you with the design principles, the best practices, and the guidance of how to achieve those things. It provides you with scenarios, customer summaries, and a glossary of what you need to think about when designing architecture for the cloud. Our tool is an interactive representation of that guidance. It provides you with a way to ask questions and answer questions that allows you to review that process and review your workloads to identify risks that might be in those workloads. We have our interactive labs. That is an interactive experience where you apply our guidance to a known workload, and we provide you insight into some of the questions that we ask. We explain to you why we ask those questions, and we teach you how to implement those questions and to ask those questions of your own workloads. We also have the Well-Architected tool. The Well-Architected tool is a service in the AWS console that allows you to go through a slew of questions about your architectural decisions that you need to make regarding the five pillars. This is a self-service tool that you can assign to all of your teams through all of your business, and it allows you to highlight any risks that we might identify. When we highlight those risks, or when we identify those risks, we also provide you with implementation details of how to remediate those risks and what steps you can take to make sure that those risks will not be a problem down the road. Then we have data. Data is the information that you have from doing the reviews and the interactive and using the interactive tools that we have. This data is key to providing those metrics that allow you to decide whether you truly are well architected or not. It allows you to measure this in your monitoring systems, in your auditing systems, and provide a detailed prescriptive guidance of what it looks like to achieve a successful, well-architected environment. In each of these three categories, we have multiple assets and multiple different content types that you can use, and they are all built to facilitate your ability to learn what a well-architected workload on AWS looks like. So if we have these foundations in the pillars, that is our key concepts and design principles and the guidance, what is a lens? A lens takes those foundations and extends on the guidance that we have for them, but in an industry and technology specific way. We realize, and through working with our customers and the feedback that they've provided us, that not all technology can be implemented in the same way, and not all workloads in all industries work and have the same requirements. So the lenses address this feedback. Our lenses allow us to be more specific about your workload and the industry-specific terms and the industry-specific requirements that you might have in that workload. It allows us to drill down on things like compliance and certain specific implementations that are tied to a specific technology set. For example, how to use high availability through replication sets in a container environment, as opposed to high availability in an EC2 auto-scaling group alone. Working with our customers, we have identified quite a few categories and groupings of industry that have diverging requirements for our guidance. For example, we have business operations, where we want to apply a view specific to management and governance. Or we have a modern infrastructure portion where we know the customers are developing serverless applications, which is still fundamentally quite new. So these lenses are the result of working with our customers and looking at the most frequently asked questions and of our customers telling us the most frequent things that they have trouble with. So we've dedicated our time to work with subject matter experts in these fields to develop prescriptive guidance for these specific workloads. We already have quite a few of our white papers and questions and inside of the tool available, but we are diligently working to add more of them. Some of the lenses that we have in the tool today that we are quite excited about is, for example, the high performance computing lens. We define high performance computing as those workloads that require the use of parallel computing at a very high scale that needs high performance in disk access, networking access, low latency, and high performance tiered storage to solve compute intensive modeling and simulation problems. That's a mouthful for most of us, but on a technological level, that becomes even more complex. There is a large array of services available that provide high-performance computing guidance and high-performance computing services to our customers. But how to incorporate them efficiently to work together in a well-architected environment can be confusing. Our HPC lens addresses this. And we not only provide you with guidance around the pillars, and we also provide you with risks that we might identify in your workloads, but we provide you with detailed reference architectures for the most commonly found architectures for HPC on AWS. These include traditional cluster environments, batch-based architecture deployments, queue-based architectural processing, hybrid deployments, and high-performance computing in a serverless environment. These all provide dedicated prescriptive guidance that we work backwards from our customers that have found success running HPC workloads on AWS. Serverless is one of the fastest growing architectural adoptions that we've seen in recent history. Customers are loving the ability to focus on their applications and the value that their applications have and leave the infrastructure management to AWS. But again, with all of our serverless technologies and serverless services that we have available, it is quite often very overwhelming for our customers to choose the right services and use them together in a well-architected manner. Our serverless applications lens provides prescriptive guidance on how to achieve all of our pillars in a secure and cost-optimized way that allows you to focus on your application and the value of that application to your customers while making sure that you will still be cost-effective, secure, that you will achieve operational excellence, and that you will thrive in this new serverless world. Those are two of our lenses that we have seen most conversations around. But those are not the only lenses that we have, and we are diligently working with our customers and our fields to find out what more we can do for customers and where and what challenges we can help them with. With that, we have some upcoming lenses like the management and governance lens, the container lens, and the SAP lens. But we also don't just write lenses and forget about those lenses. We quite frequently update our lenses with new guidance as we learn what best practices apply to them. If a new technology launches that has a significant impact on the way that our customers run those workloads in the cloud, we update our lenses. So this year, you'll see an update in our analytics lens that has also given the birth of our data management lens, where that data management lens will also incorporate some guidance and also arch into our big data lens. Our IoT lens will have a very short, will shortly come out with some updated guidance around some of our new released edge services as well. We're very excited about the management and governance lens. The management and governance lens has been a highly requested lens from our customers. It's one thing to know how to run the technology in your account, or it's one thing to know how to architect your application in such a way that it is technologically sound. But our customers also really want to know how they can manage their businesses through a large array of accounts and different business units and different technology requirements with teams using different technologies, et cetera, et cetera. So the management and governance lens allows us to address those questions. And inside of this lens, we've identified 8 capabilities that we know makes a customer successful when they have a polyglot environment with multiple teams working on different projects and different programs, but running in AWS. Those 8 capabilities are to have control and guardrails. In other words, to have a highway that many cars can drive on, but to have road rules. And you can drive any car that you want on that highway, but you still need to adhere to the rules of the road. So controls and guardrails. How does network and connectivity work between all of your multiple AWS accounts, VPCs, and common infrastructures? How do you manage identity and access management between those products and services that might not reside inside of the same account? How do you approach security operations for new applications that get deployed and developed across a large structural business? How do you make all of your applications and all of the things that you do observable for your IT infrastructure teams and for your management teams. Cloud financial management is also very important in a distributed business like this. How do you do service management for microservices? And finally, what does sourcing and distribution look like? The management and governance lens focuses on answering these questions. It allows you to take a prescriptive approach based on all of the evidence and the experience that we've had with customers building workloads on AWS and apply that to your own workload. Another highly requested lens has been the SAP lens. SAP workloads are quite tricky. And because of the specific technology required and implemented in SAP, it doesn't always adhere to our common best practices guidance around things like high availability, security, and data management. Specifically because the SAP technology itself already implements certain mechanisms and technological and architectural choices that provide high availability in the software layer. It makes it redundant, therefore, to deploy certain things using an EC2 autoscaling group across multiple AZs, etc., etc. The SAP workloads, the SAP lens provides prescriptive guidance specific to those topics that allows you to understand how to make use of those software-level high availability features and other software-level features included in the SAP workloads, together with the infrastructural best practices and infrastructural capabilities that you provide, that you get from using AWS. I invite you to take a look at all of the AWS white papers that we have out there today. Visit our websites where you can see our narrative guidance in the white paper for all of our pillars, as well as the existing lenses, and to keep a lookout for all of the new lenses that we will be publishing in 2020. Review your workloads. Take our interactive labs to learn how to do it. Then use our well-architected tool inside of the console, which is completely free, to review your workloads. Find out what risks there might be in your workloads and inside of your architectural decisions, and then work to resolve them. If you have any questions or if you have any feedback, please reach out to us at the Well-Architected team. Thank you very much for taking the time to listen to this session, and I hope to see you inside of the Well-Architected tool.